So people celebrate, of course, Lent, and it is Lenten season. Ash Wednesday was last Wednesday, the same day as Valentine's Day. And you know, fish fries are super popular, but let's make some stuff at home and let's make some crab cakes from Lunds and Byerly's. Michael Selby is here, and we're gonna make some homemade gluten-free, wonderful crab cakes. But I was at the store up in White Bear Lake on Thursday with my mom, and I saw they were all on sale, and they're beautiful. So if you don't wanna do that, you could go buy your own right there, which is a great idea as well.
Yes, you certainly can. So today we're gonna go over a home version recipe of the crab cakes.
Okay.
And they're gluten friendly. This recipe was developed in our innovation kitchen by our executive chef, Anthony Leonardi.
They look really good.
What makes this recipe a little bit different is how it's mixed. So in the bowl right now, I've got egg yolk, Dijon mustard, and Kensington mayo that's got better flavor and so forth.
I do like that mayo.
I do too.
I have tried that before.
So in goes the parsley.
All right.
And notice how we don't over chop it. We want it just kind of almost like a shredded kind of look, okay?
Okay.
In goes the lump crab meat. You can stir that in.
So do you buy the lump crab or do you sell it? Is that Miller's? Is that the one you buy?
One of them. Yep.
One of them? Okay.
Yep,
I like that.
This is a wild caught blue crab.
All right.
So we're mixing that in. And what makes this difference, we don't want to overmix it because we're going to put the breadcrumbs in right now. That way we don't have to bread them after it's mixed and so forth.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
So you just do it really lightly then,
not a lot.
Yep, okay.
Just slowly kind of fold that in. And
okay.
This is gluten friendly. You certainly can use puffed rice or cooked rice if you'd like to, but this is a gluten-free panko.
Because, panko, you have a gluten-free panko available.
We do.
Okay.
We do.
Okay.
We do. Yeah. So once that's evenly incorporated, you know, we're using lump crab, so we want to have those nooks and crannies in there. We don't want it over-packed or over-mixed.
That's such a good point.
Right, so the lumps really come out with flavor, right?
So what'd you put in your cast iron pan?
So from here, we've got avocado oil, and we're just slowly cooking it about 4 or 5 minutes aside. And again, with this mix, you can do appetizer size, you can do...
Oh yeah, this is such a good idea. So
yeah.
Little ones, or you can make these more that you can roast off, right?
Correct. Yeah, that is simply 425 oven for about 10 minutes.
Okay.
Air fryer is great too.
And the little ones are in, you put them in there.
Yep, absolutely.
And do you suggest a cast iron pan?
I do. That's always best.
Yeah, that's really great.
But, you know, the sky's the limit, really. You can.
Okay. And
yeah,
then what did you put on the bottom here
sure.
when this gets done?
Yeah, so what we've got here is obviously a little surf and turf here.
That looks really good. Nothing
so
wrong
we're
with
just
that,
gonna
right?
Go right on the plate here.
Oh, wow, look at this.
Yeah.
And then a beautiful little salad, I noticed, with oranges.
Mm-hmm.
And is that?
Yeah, you could pick your favorite finishing sauce, right? A bottom of the plate. And then just a simple.
Oh, a sriracha horseradish, Chris.
Yeah, all of those sauces are fantastic. Very versatile for appetizers and entrees like this.
Goodness.
So just a simple fennel green salad.
Just right. Oh, look how pretty
that
is. See, now you're going to look like a chef at your own house.
Yes.
Almost
yes,
as good
are.
As you.
Well,
hey, I love this. We want to let people know how they can get this recipe. And thanks
Absolutely.
For sharing with us. And of course, at Lunds and Byerly's, they have all this stuff. And of course, you can just buy it if you don't want to make it. But you can buy and make it too, because you can go to KARE11.com and you can go ahead and text the word recipe to 763-797-7215. Or there's a QR code on the bottom. We'll be right back.